Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I want to discuss social engineering by the establishment vis-a-vis Islam. How it's happening, why it's happening, and since when it started. Do you remember Tony Blair saying that there is a good Islam and bad Islam? A good Islam was Islam which was compatible with the Zionist and with the establishment, and the bad Islam was the one which was defined by Muslims based on the Quran and the Sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, that is being pushed by different governments at different times in a different shapes and form, even with prevent and other activities to try social engineer and control Muslim beyond any other religious group. What is happening now is a charity commission and its power has been brought in to implement this social engineering. We see in the Islamic Centre of England in London, and indeed another mosque in Birmingham, there has been an interim manager forced on those communities to define what they should do, what they shouldn't do, what changes should take place by bringing and enforcing new trustees on that community, rather than the community itself. Those who worship, those who have built the place, those who have financed the place are the ones that should be defining who their trustees should be. You're not doing this with the synagogue or the churches or the Hindu temple or Sikh temples. Why are you doing it with Muslim centers? This sort of level of interference to implement the social engineering is totally unacceptable by any government, let alone a secular government. And the fact of the matter is, there is no shred of evidence being presented that the current trustees have done anything unlawful. What is being very clear, what you could do in the other places of worship or at universities or anywhere else cannot be done in the mosque, because mosques have to be run according to wishes of a secular government who define what is good Islam and what is bad Islam.